This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this video is going to be about complementary and supplementary angles. So let's start with complementary angles. If I have two angles and their measures add up to 90 degrees, we can say that those two angles are complementary. So if angle A equals, let's say, 30 degrees, and angle B equals 60 degrees, then since 60 plus 30 is 90, we can call these complementary angles. If you put two complementary angles together, you're going to get a right angle. So here's a right angle. Let's say that we have divided that into two adjacent angles. One is 30 degrees and one is 60 degrees. Well, 30 plus 60 is 90. And a right angle is a 90 degree angle. Now, that doesn't mean that angles have to be next to each other. It doesn't mean they have to be adjacent for them to be complementary. So I might have a triangle, and one of the angles of the triangle might be 30 degrees, and another angle might be 60 degrees. Even though they're not adjacent, those two angles are still complementary angles. If we're given one angle, we can find the size of its complementary angle. So if I'm told that angle A equals, let's say, 62 degrees, then I can find angle B. All I have to do is remember that angle A and angle B, angle A plus angle B, if they're going to be complementary, would have to add up to 90 degrees. Angle A, we're saying, measured 62 degrees, so 62 degrees plus angle B would equal 90 degrees. And then when I subtract 62 degrees from both sides, I would find that angle B equals 28 degrees. Okay? So basically, complementary angles added together are going to have a measure of 90 degrees. As supplementary angles are going to add up to 180 degrees, if we have, let's say, angle A, and angle A is 50 degrees, and angle B is 130 degrees, then since 50 plus 130 equals 180, we could say that angles A and B are supplementary. If they're adjacent to each other, they're going to form a straight angle. So if I draw a straight line and I have one angle that's 50 degrees and another angle adjacent to it that's 130 degrees, then those two angles together will add up to 180 degrees, which will form a straight angle. Okay, so supplementary angles add up together to 180 degrees. If we place them together, we're going to have a straight line. Once again, like complementary angles, they don't have to be adjacent. But if they are adjacent, they'll form a straight angle. And like complementary angles, if we know one of the angles, if we know that, let's say, angle A is 145 degrees, and we want to find angle B so that angle A and B are supplementary angles, then we could say that angle A plus angle B, that their measures equal 180 degrees. If angle A is 145 degrees, then that means 145 degrees plus the measure of angle B will be 180 degrees. We would subtract 145 from both sides of the equation, and we find out that angle B is going to equal 35 degrees. So angle A is 145 degrees, angle B is 35 degrees. They add up together to 180 degrees, so they're going to be supplementary. And that's really about all there is to it. Take care. I'll see you next time.